I'm hating it. Hating it. But I just wanted to start the video while I actually have acne, so that you know that I'm currently struggling and everything I say is real and what I've done, and this is like a completely honest journal of what I've tried. Good morning, guys. So if you are watching this video, it's probably because you suffer with hormonal acne. Maybe you don't know what hormone is causing the problem, or what to do about it. So for those of you who don't know me, my name is Madison Dohnt, and basically my health journey started when I developed severe adult acne at the end of 2018. So thankfully, due to my science degree, I have pretty solid research skills. So for months, pretty much every night I would be up until 2 a.m. just researching, reading scientific articles, and it was intense. But basically I was on a mission to heal myself of acne and also then to get myself off hormonal birth control, because I've been on hormonal birth control for 7.5 years, and that whole time I would always have at least one cystic pimple, and the day that that one would go away would be the same day that I would get a new one. So I just knew that it wasn't doing me any favors. I knew that it wasn't fixing the problem. So I wanted to get rid of the acne and then balance my hormones without hormonal birth control. So now what I'm doing is I'm going back to uni to study my third degree. Yes, I know I'm crazy. And that degree is going to be in naturopathy. So basically, I'm so excited to be studying about the body's natural ability to heal itself. So the way I work is I acknowledge that everyone is different and the same thing doesn't work for everybody. So the point of this channel is I want to educate you and teach you how to understand your own body so that you can actually listen to what it's telling you and heal yourself naturally by giving your body what it needs. If this sounds like something that you might want to learn, then make sure that you subscribe to this channel. You can also hit the little notification bell beside that, because that will notify you every time I bring out a new video, which is going to be every Sunday. Also, just to note, this channel is not just going to be on hormonal acne, it's going to be on all things health and also everything that I learn in my naturopathy course, but I just thought that I would start with hormonal acne, seeing as that's kind of what's changed my path in life and brought me to creating this channel. And look, like I said, I know what it's like to be up until all hours of the morning trying to pick apart the good advice from the bad, but I can promise you that everything I will bring to you in this video and in my channel will be things that I've either learnt through my course or things that I have researched, and they are backed up by research studies, so they're scientifically significant. And I will link the studies below in the description of this video too. So in this video, we're going to go through what hormone causes acne and why it does. We're also going to go through why we can't just get rid of this acne-causing hormone altogether, although some might think that would be nice. And then I'm going to go through some things that you can do to naturally lower this hormone back down to normal levels. And then finally, I'm going to discuss why birth control, hormonal birth control, is probably not the best idea for controlling your acne. And I know this information will help you, because I've used it to heal my hormonal acne, as well as all the other tips that I'm going to be sharing with you on this channel as well. So let's start with what hormone is actually causing the acne and why. So it's an increase in testosterone that causes acne because it increases the production of oil called sebum. So basically the pores in our skin, they have a sebaceous gland, and that is the one that creates the oil. So there's three things that cause every pimple. I'm only going to discuss the oil, which is caused by the excess testosterone, in this video, but I'm going to cover the other two on another video coming up on the 21st of July. So sebum is really, really important in moisturizing our skin, protecting us from infection, and also clearing out dead skin cells. The problem comes when we have an overproduction of sebum because of an excess of testosterone. So what happens now is, instead of clearing the dead skin cells, it traps them, and the pores get clogged with the dead skin cells, and this causes acne bacteria to grow and overpopulate, and then you have your pimple. So with this being said, it makes sense that acne is more common during puberty, because puberty is when the sebaceous glands activate, so naturally your face is more oily. But just remember that sebum is not all bad. It's just when you get too much that it starts causing problems, just like too much of anything. Okay, so now that we know how testosterone can cause a problem, let's go through why women still need testosterone. So basically, testosterone is super important in improving our mood, increasing our libido, boosting our energy levels, promoting the growth of strong bones and muscles, and also for growing long, healthy hair. So testosterone is higher in men and known as the male hormone, as back in the day, long ago, males were the ones that had to hunt for food and compete for females so that they could reproduce and pass on their genes. So without energy, strength, and an increased libido to motivate them, the male species wouldn't be very successful. So without testosterone, women would be depressed, have no sex drive, they would be constantly tired, and they would feel weak. So yeah, it's super important. We can't just get rid of it altogether. But yeah, we do need to, if you've got too high testosterone and that's causing your breakouts, we do need to bring those levels back down to normal. So now that you know what it looks like to have too high testosterone or too low testosterone, comment down below which one you think that you have and why. Most likely you guys are watching this channel because you have too high testosterone and therefore it's causing you to break out. So let's go through a couple of natural things that you can use in order to lower those testosterone levels back down to normal. Also, like I mentioned before, I'll pop the studies quickly up on the screen, but also down in the description if you want to have a read of those, just so that you know that all these tips have been scientifically proven. Okay, so number one is licorice tea, my favorite. So licorice has been significantly shown to lower androgens. So androgens is the collective term for male hormones and therefore testosterone. So I don't like licorice, let's just start by saying that. However, licorice tea tastes amazing. Mum had some in her cupboard for 3 weeks and kept asking me to try it, but I was like, no, I don't think I'll like it. And she's like, just have a tea bag and try it, and if you don't like it, throw it out. And I was like, no, I hate wasting things. But when I did eventually decide to try it, I can promise you that it tastes so good. Like, I'm actually addicted more than I have ever been with any other tea. So I think for the first couple months I was having like one a day. So yeah, I highly recommend licorice tea. And if you are worried about trying it, remember it doesn't taste like licorice. It kind of tastes herbally, but then the aftertaste is sweet. So I don't really like sweet teas, but you kind of get like the best of both worlds. So make sure to try it. The second one is spearmint and peppermint. So these have both been shown to significantly reduce testosterone. And what's even better is that the tea that I was just telling you about also has organic peppermint leaves in it. So I will throw it up on the screen and show you the ingredients. So I highly recommend that you try this tea because, like I said, it tastes really good, and that's going to help you lower your testosterone levels. Okay, so number three is nuts, especially almonds and walnuts have been shown to lower free androgens in the body. So if you are already dairy free for acne, then that's good, and you're probably having almond milk, so already you're getting some almonds in there, although almond milk is not 100% almonds. But also you should be snacking on nuts throughout the day, because another one that's been proven to lower testosterone is also omega-3 fats. So they're your healthy fats. So if you snack on nuts, then you're also getting a good amount of those. It also helps regulate irregular periods as well, so try and get onto that. And number four, due to being a rich source of lignin, flax seeds are excellent at reducing the androgens in the body as well. They have been significantly shown to reduce androgens in men with prostate cancer and also in women with PCOS. So flaxseed is a really easy one to just throw in your smoothie, and I'll also pop my pink raspberry smoothie recipe down in the comments if you want to try that one out. So smoothies are one of the easiest ways to get some extra supplements into your diet as well. Now, just a quick bonus tip, sugar and alcohol also makes a huge difference in your acne, but you probably already knew that and didn't want me to tell you again. So I recommend trying these tips out for 6 to 8 weeks, as usually that's how long it takes to see a significant difference. If you just try it for 2 days and then you don't see any difference and you're like, nope, that didn't work for me, and then you haven't actually given it a fair shot. So especially if you are someone who is considering hormonal birth control to help control your acne, I highly recommend that you try these tips for 6 to 8 weeks first, and then if you don't see a difference, you can try some other things as well. So the reason why I think going on hormonal birth control is a bad idea if you are trying to clear your acne is because basically hormonal birth control, such as the pill or other methods of birth control that release hormones into your body, they're basically telling your body to move over, shut up, and they're gonna do the work for it. So what happens as a result of this is that your brain and your ovaries stop communicating, and that's why it can sometimes take women over a year, even with intervention, to get their periods back after going off birth control, because your body kind of forgets how to communicate with your ovaries and how to produce those hormones itself. Now, also, I don't know if you knew this, but the periods that you experience on the pill are also not true menstrual periods. So they are what's called withdrawal bleeds. And what that is it looks the same as a period, but basically it's due to the sudden drop in hormones. So if you went on the pill at 16 and now you're 26, then that means that you haven't had a true menstrual period in 10 years. And that's not good. But do remember that the pill is not all bad. It does serve as a very convenient method for contraception and preventing a lot of unwanted pregnancies. However, if you kind of care about the internal state of your body and the internal balance, or if you are just specifically on the pill to clear symptoms such as acne or even other symptoms, I highly urge you to reconsider, because like I said, it's not a fix. It's just kind of masking the symptoms for now. So the real issue is that we have learnt to tell our symptoms to shut up by suppressing them with the pill instead of going, hang on, maybe my body's trying to tell me something's not right. And that right there is why I was so passionate to start this channel, because I really want to teach people how to understand their own bodies so that they can have the power to listen to what it's saying and therefore heal yourself naturally without kind of telling your symptoms to shut up. So if you liked this video and you're really excited to learn how to do this, then make sure to like this video below, subscribe, hit the little notification bell, and share it with your friends. Even if your friends are not struggling with acne, I'm going to be covering all different symptoms on this channel and everything health related. So it's free to share, and they may be struggling with their own symptoms, so it could really help them out. And like I said, as I continue my studies, I'm going to be sharing everything that I learn with you. So it's pretty much free naturopathic advice straight here on this channel. I know that when I was struggling with acne, I really wanted to see a naturopath, but I just couldn't afford it. So I know that that naturopathic advice would have really helped me and made a difference to speed up my recovery. So I really hope that it helps you too. So now that we've gone over what hormone causes acne, my next video is going to be on what supplements to take for acne, tested by yours truly. Also, if you want to join my community, I have a new Instagram, so you can jump over and follow that one. I try and keep my captions, stories, and IGTVs super helpful, and I always love when you guys jump into my DMs and share your stories on hormonal acne or whatever you're going through with me, and then we can go through it together. I also urge you to jump down in the comments of this video and let me know if it helped, and also you can let me know what else you would like me to cover on this channel. In saying that, I hope this video really did help you. Thank you so much for listening, and I am so excited to be going back to uni and to be learning more about the incredible human body and to share it all with you so that hopefully you too can heal yourself naturally. So thank you, and I will see you in the next video.